I then went to Cambridge, because that's where I'd come to England. I hadn't yet been assigned a college. And it was not even term or half term or full term or any of these strange names that they have in Cambridge. It was a week, no, it was a month before term ended. It was it was mid-August, I guess. No, it was the first week in September, actually. The first week in September. So, of course, the undergraduates certainly weren't back. There were some graduate students around. So I went into Emeléus's room. I'd just come off the ship. I had two big hand luggage. The rest had been put into storage. And I had a big, long overcoat, trench coat on. Unbeknown to me, it was an unprecedented heat wave in Cambridge. It was, I think it was actually 89 degrees or something like that. It was really well into the mid-30s. And Emeléus's first remark to me was, good God, man, take your coat off. You must be boiling. And I said, yes, it is rather warm, isn't it? So perhaps I was picking up English understatement already. But anyway, I was glad to take my coat off. But he said, there's no point in coming to work at the moment. No one's here. They've gone to conferences or on holidays and so forth. And I haven't got you into college yet. Why don't you look around England for a month and come back in the first week in October and we'll settle things then. But you're definitely in. I've got a place for you in my laboratory. And he then took me to the Red Lion, which I don't think is a pub anymore. I think Lion's Yard, it's in Petticoorie.
Yes, it's disappeared, Norman, sadly.
I think
it has. The Lion's still there, but the pub's gone.
Okay, well, it was the Lion in Petticoorie. Mm-hmm. And again, in his own inimical way, he said, Norman, I'll leave you to the pleasures of finding out about Cambridge on your own. And so I bought a guidebook and decided to walk around Cambridge.